my plea in Michigan, and it be my plea until the last breath I draw and the last word I speak, is education for all children, all men, and all women of Michigan, all the people, in all our states, all the time.
Graduates in the Doctorate in Community College Leadership Program. Gentlemen, the graduates of the College of Arts and Sciences. Thank you. ladies and gentlemen, the faculty representatives of Ferris State University. Ladies and gentlemen, the President and stage dignitaries. For the singing of our national anthem. Feel free to join soloist Rachel Schumann. Gentlemen, please remove your hats.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, over the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rockets red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, star-spangled banner yet wave over the land of the free and the home of the brave.
You may be seated. good evening, and welcome to the commencement exercises of Ferris State University. We are delighted that you, the families and friends of our graduates, have come to witness this occasion which celebrates their accomplishments. My name is Sandy Alsbaugh. I'm a faculty member in the College of Arts and Sciences. Carrying the symbolic mace and representing the Academic Senate is David Bright. Marshals representing the faculty members are J.L. Olenquist and Dale Scornia. Today's music is performed by the Brass Quintet from Mount Pleasant. The interpreter is Emily Baxter. And the ushers are members of the Ferris State University Student Alumni Gold Club. Please join me in thanking them for their assistance. Now allow me to present the stage dignitaries who will rise as they are introduced. Audience, please hold your applause until all have been recognized. Board of Trustee member Alicia M. Baker from Mount Clemens. President David L. Eisler. Honorary doctorate candidate Vivian R. Picard. Provost and Vice President for Academic Affairs Paul A. Blake. It is a special pleasure to recognize retiring professor Dr. Philip Middleton, professor languages and literature, serving 27 years, who has assisted Ferris students with particular distinction over his long career. Academic Senate President Kagendra Tapa. Associate Vice President for External Relations and Executive Director of the Ferris Alumni Association, Jeremy J. Mishler. Vice President for Student Affairs, Janine A. Ward-Roof. Trustee Arthur L. Thibault from Walloon Lake. Vice President for University Advancement and Marketing, Shelley L. Piercy. Vice President for Diversity and Inclusion, David Pilgrim. Vice President and General Counsel, Miles J. Postema. Vice President for Administration and Finance, Jerry L. Scobie. College of Health Professions, Dean Matthew O. Adeyanju. Library Dean, Scott Garrison. College of Business Dean, David M. Nickel. College of Education and Human Services Dean, Stephen E. Reifert. College of Engineering Technology Dean, Larry L. Schultz. College of Arts and Sciences Dean, Andy Carfa. Extended and International Operations Dean, Cheryl K. Clucci. College of Pharmacy Dean, Stephen W. Durst. Would you please join me in acknowledging them? Officially presiding over the commencement ceremony are members of the Board of Trustees of Ferris State University. President Eisler now brings you the university's greetings.
It is a pleasure to welcome each of you, family, friends, honored guests, members of our Board of Trustees, faculty and staff colleagues, and most importantly, you, our graduates. As a university community, we are immensely proud of each of you today. It is an honor to stand before you, the class of 2016. Today is a wonderful opportunity for you to reflect on your accomplishments here at Ferris State University. At such a time, you need to know that your success is built upon the collective efforts of so many people who care deeply about you and who take great pride in your growth and development. I want to pause for a moment so we can express our thanks. I begin with our faculty who have served as your teachers, advisors, guides, and mentors. We are truly fortunate to have a faculty at Ferris State University who are dedicated to teaching and who care deeply about students. I would ask that our faculty rise so we can express our thanks to them. I also want to thank our staff who each contribute in their way for you, our students. In doing so, I would note their many contributions to our ceremony and the pride they take in it. The beautiful decorations here today and the commencement program, which provides information on our university, the degrees it offers, and today's ceremony. Now to the special guests with us today.
First, I want to recognize your parents. They have planned and sacrificed to help you reach this pinnacle of achievement. Parents, please stand. I'd be willing to guess that there are also proud grandparents here. Would grandparents please stand? For some of our graduates, there are spouses or significant others who have stood by them in both good and tough times and have supported you working toward this day. Would you please stand? Graduates, some of you also have children who have had to share their mom or dad with books, studying, and homework assignments. I'd ask the children of our graduates to stand. Finally, we have many friends and other relatives of our graduates here. Please stand so we can thank you for being here with us today. Graduates, in a few moments you'll be crossing the stage. Two helpful reminders. As you celebrate this achievement, take time to thank those who have worked, helped, and supported you. Their sacrifice and love have helped create this moment for you. Second, a practical but useful reminder. We're going to take your picture as you receive your degree. Don't forget to pause as I shake your hand and smile. Each one of our graduates today has a story to tell. Family and friends, teachers and mentors play an important part in the success of virtually all of our graduates. Also, it's the dedication of our graduates that's led to the walk across the stage to receive their diplomas. I wish I could tell the stories of every one of our graduates because each one is special and represents the commitment and achievement that brings them to this stage today. As examples, I want to highlight the stories of two graduates whose journeys illustrate both the individual fortitude it takes to overcome adversity, as well as the supportive role others so often play in our success. This graduate from Flushing, Michigan grew up riding horses. She showed horses with her family for many years. She also showed with her high school equestrian team, as well as for Ferris equestrian team during her first year as an undergraduate. Pharmacy was a profession that called to her early on. In high school, she worked summer at Diplomat Pharmacy, a practice she continued for her first years here at Ferris. She decided to attend Ferris because it was not as large as some of the other schools with programs in the state. She thought that she would not get overlooked here and was looking for the personal attention we provide. As an undergraduate, she worked very hard to get the grades she would need to be accepted into pharmacy school. Something this graduate has shared with very few people is that she has a chronic medical condition. That condition flared up near the end of her first undergraduate semester in late December, as she realized that she needed to be admitted to a hospital for treatment. It was the first time she'd had to do this on her own. She had to get IV antibiotics shipped to her residence hall and have nurses visit her. This was a 3 to 4 week treatment, so she had to continue this regimen when her classes started back up again in January. To help when she returned in January, this graduate's mother actually moved into her residence hall room for a week, sleeping on a futon. I remember how she described it to me. She said, "Mom, you're going to get me tossed out of here. No one knows you're here." Her treatments were 3 times a day for 2 hours each. So she would have to start her first treatment at 6 a.m., have a late afternoon treatment, and complete the cycle from 10 to midnight. The process would begin again at 6 the next morning so she could get to class at 8 a.m. After 2 years of undergraduate study, she was accepted in the pharmacy program. The first 2 years of pharmacy school were a challenge for this graduate. The increased workload of graduate school again made her chronic condition worse, to the point that some days she could not get out of bed to make it to class, could not get her assignments done. She reached out to Dr. Jeff Bates for help. This is not something she was used to doing. She says that she has always wanted people to see her for herself, not for her disease. So she was not used to telling people about her medical history. At the end of her first pharmacy semester, she again required treatment with IV antibiotics. Today, she graduates with her doctorate in pharmacy, with few people knowing that she completed this rigorous course of study while dealing with the effects of cystic fibrosis. After graduation, she will serve as a general inpatient residency at St. Joseph Mercy Oakland Hospital in Pontiac. Longer term, in part because of her own experience, she would like to focus her practice on chronic disease management. She says she is grateful to her family and friends who supported her throughout the process. In doing so, she thanks her family, especially her mother, Shelley, her father and stepfather, Pete and Casey, grandmother, Carol, and younger sisters, Maddie and Jordan. She also thanks Dr. Bates for his help, as well as her close friend, Allie Wasick, and her boyfriend, Kirk White. It is my great pleasure to present to you a courageous and remarkable graduate, Michelle Stewart, and would ask that she stand and be recognized. Michelle? Would Michelle's family also stand? If you attended Art Prize last year, you may have seen this next graduate. She was featured in an entry that consisted of a life-size photographic portrait of her with the text of a poem she wrote about positive body image, a part of which reads, "My hope is that as humanity, we can learn to see each other's bodies as if they were a gift." This graduate has many gifts, including determination. She began her path to degree at Calvin College, completing nearly 3 years there. Life-threatening health challenges developed for her, forcing her to the hospital and home to recover. She enrolled at Ferris in the fall of 2010, taking a part-time load to work toward her bachelor in integrative studies, focusing on religious studies and gender studies. Since that time, she has been very active both inside and outside of the classroom. She's a member of the Vocal Lyrica Women's Choir. She also works for the United Church of Big Rapids as director of children's choirs and also as co-Christian education director. In addition to her faith and passion for music, this graduate is, like Michelle, an avid horseback rider. She says that when she's riding, you wouldn't see her any differently than any other rider. In her poem in the Art Prize submission, she says, "I'm a person with a challenge like everyone else. My challenge is just more immediately visible." What makes her own challenge more visible is a mild form of cerebral palsy. However, she stresses that her condition doesn't separate her from people, but connects her to them. Everyone's life is hard in one way or the other, she says. A lot of people struggle with things you can't immediately see. While some students take a gap year between high school and college to consider what they want to study, this graduate plans to do so between her undergraduate and graduate work. She's taking social work classes after graduation to see if that is a path she might want to follow. She is also considering continuing her spiritual journey by entering seminary. In graduating today, this graduate wants to thank her parents, John and Shirley, her brother and sister-in-law, Jeff and Courtney, her nephew, Simon. At Ferris, she wants to thank Roxanne Cullen, Rebecca Samuel, Susan Morris, Krishna Kali Mazumdada, Tracy Webb, Lisa Ling and her family, Wendy Samuels and her family, Kim Carlton Smith, Marie Yautz, Gustavo Rodriguez Moran, Randy Groves, Lynette Vaught, Doug Workman, and many others. She also thanks a community of friends too large to name individually for their love and support. It is my great pleasure to present to you a truly gifted and determined graduate, Emily Garlick, when asked that she stand and be recognized. And I'd also ask that Emily's family stand. Graduates, on behalf of our university, I wish you great success and fulfillment as you begin the next stage of your journey. In addition to the times of success and advancement, you will inevitably face times of challenge and uncertainty. Michelle Stewart and Emily Garlick offer truly extraordinary examples of how the human spirit can not only persevere, but triumph over adversity. They refuse to allow the most challenging of circumstances to limit or define them, but instead drew upon the resources inside them and with the assistance of others, moved forward, achieving their goals and building a successful future. Congratulations and best wishes, class of 2016.
Provost and Vice President for Academic Affairs, Paul Blake, will introduce the honorary doctorate candidate.
Good evening. We are honored today to recommend a Ferris alumna who has a distinguished history as a community advocate and philanthropist. We are proud to recognize Vivian Rogers Picard. Allow me to share the resolution concerning our honorary doctorate candidate, Ms. Picard. Honorary degree, Doctor of Humane Letters. Whereas, Vivian Rogers Picard, you are Director of General Motors Community Partnerships in Southeast Michigan, responsible for leading the company's efforts to strengthen its headquarters region through partnerships and investments in the areas of education, health, and human services, the environment, and community development. Whereas your long career with General Motors includes such key roles as president of the GM Foundation and other important administrative and management positions within the finance, human resources, and public policy functions. Whereas you are a community advocate and philanthropist, serving on the board for Habitat for Humanity International, Detroit Regional Chamber Foundation, Fifth Third Bank Eastern Michigan, and others. Whereas you also are an officer for the Detroit Economic Club, a former member of the National Urban League's National Employer Advisory Council, immediate past president for the Black Women's Agenda Incorporated, and are a lifetime member of the NAACP, the National Council of Negro Women, the National Black MBA Association, and are a graduate of Leadership Detroit Class 7. Whereas your awards for community service include the Spirit of the Dream Award from the United Negro College Fund, the Global Community Award at the 2014 North American International Auto Show Multicultural Media Luncheon, and being named by the Michigan Chronicle as one of the 50 most powerful African Americans in southeastern Michigan. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the Board of Trustees of Ferris State University offers to you its sincere gratitude and takes great pride in conferring upon you the honorary degree, Doctor of Humane Letters, with all the rights, privileges thereunto pertaining.
Vivian Rogers Picard, Ferris State University is privileged to pay tribute to you today by virtue of the laws of the state of Michigan and the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of Ferris State University. And with the sincere good wishes of the faculty and students of this university, I confer upon you the honorary degree, Doctor of Humane Letters, with all the rights and privileges therein. As a symbol of this recognition, we invest you with this doctoral hood. And present you with this diploma, Dr. Picard. May I present to you Dr. Vivian Picard.
Good evening, everyone. To President Eisler, members of the Board of Directors, faculty, 2016 graduates, family, and friends. I am humbled by this kind gesture from an institution that I love dearly. To receive this honor from this institution that has already given me more than I can ever expect is very heartwarming. I have thought much about my years at Ferris since President Eisler came to my office to advise me of this honor. I have thought about what I took with me when I left the school. The first thing I must acknowledge are lifelong friends. I also took with me the ability to be disciplined, to be humble, to share, to care. I learned the ability to work in a team and how everyone has something to offer and must contribute. I learned that a B was as good as an A, as long as I did my very best. Later confirming in life that a manager is just as significant as a director, as long as I had left the office every day having done my very best. These may sound like small things and common sense, but I have to let you all know that after 40 years, these small things have helped me so much in my career. I have also abided by a few guidelines throughout my career. Always be ethical. Always do what you believe is right. And lastly, always be you. You are walking into a future of very unlimited possibilities. It now falls on you to make choices that will impact you for the rest of your lives. Ferris State University has provided you with the intellect to find employment, but make sure that you serve your employer in a way that is ethical and meaningful. Go in with a very conscious decision that you will do your very best. And I want you to listen to this piece of advice very carefully. Be careful what you place on Facebook, Instagram, and all of the other social media outlets. I personally have seen so many individuals fired or not provided the opportunities because of choices they made on these social media outlets. Once you hit send, it could be the end of a great opportunity. And graduates, you and your parents have worked too hard for that to happen. I would like to leave you with one piece of advice, and I will put it in the content where you will remember it. And I also know that this may hit home with many of you, because I remember 4 years, so I know what you've been doing for the last 4 years. There are many parallels between a job and a good bottle of wine. Or in this instance, a slightly inexpensive bottle of wine. They both require a combination of discipline, patience, know-how, smart work, the right ingredients, and a little bit of chemistry. If all of these things come together just right, like a good bottle of wine, you end up with a job that is thoroughly enjoyable and gets better as you age and grow. I hope you will offer the right ingredients to your employer and that you will return just like a good bottle of wine. You will also become the very special employee that that organization cannot do without. And I personally know what you're going through today because I've been there. You're excited, you're fearful, and many other emotions. And this is only natural. There are thousands of graduates that are feeling the same way you are feeling, and this too will pass. I wish you best for a healthy, happy, and a productive life as you transition to your next phase. I wish each and every one of you the opportunity to be on this stage receiving the same honor that I am receiving today. And again, to the leadership of Ferris, I thank you for this honor.
I learned tonight that Dr. Picard is one of 9 brothers and sisters, and they are all here tonight. I'd like to ask them to stand, if they would. Please stand. Is that fabulous? What a family. Thank you for being with us.
And I'm only allowed to get off script when the president says so. We now take great pride in recognizing the graduates of the Ferris State University Class of 2016. In the interest of time and maintaining the integrity of the ceremony, we ask that the families and friends of the graduates remain at their seats for the complete ceremony. The university has contracted with a professional photographer to take pictures of each graduate. Following the ceremony, we invite the family and friends to take photos in front of the stage. For safety purposes, the platform will be closed. The academic deans will assist President Eisler and Provost Blake to confer the appropriate degrees and certificates on the Ferris State University Class of 2016.
Will the candidates for the Doctor of Pharmacy degree in the College of Pharmacy please rise? Will their families also rise? Dean Stephen Durst will present the candidates.
On behalf of the College of Pharmacy, I'm honored to present these candidates for the degree of Doctor of Pharmacy. They are hereby certified by the faculty for their degrees. The special hoods they wear represent the completion of the requirement for the doctoral degree.
By virtue of the authority vested in me, I confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Pharmacy with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities therein. Congratulations, doctoral graduates, College of Pharmacy.
Family members may be seated. Graduates may be seated except for the first row. Please come forward as directed by the ushers. Dr. Jennifer Hoover. Dr. Tianta Perry. Dr. Hope Buell. Dr. Sherry Nguyen. Dr. Linda Town. Dr. Leah Double. Dr. Stephanie Berry. Dr. Ali Wasik. Dr. Michelle Stewart. Dr. Edward Wright. Dr. Natalie Yunker. Dr. Amara Wilson. Dr. Brooke Crandall. Dr. Brett Johnson. Dr. Albert Keith Lippitt. Dr. Mary Wilmansky. Dr. Brian Hook. Dr. Derek Huvian. Dr. Samuel Laugel. Dr. Christopher Lay. Dr. Ryan Ozanek. Dr. Joseph Laycock. Dr. Rachel Schaposky. Dr. Lauren Steinhaus. Dr. Michelle Saar. Dr. Lisa Shermans. Dr. Jennifer Gregory. Dr. Rachel McCollum. Dr. Hannah Beard. Dr. Callie Sterenberg. Dr. Nathan Allison. Dr. Jacob Chaffee. Dr. Catherine Donnelly. Dr. Emily Pohl. Dr. Emma Holney. Dr. Stanley Urban. Dr. Sean Duchesne. Dr. Amanda Zinn. Dr. Kelly Brusso. Dr. Nicole Johnson. Dr. Sarah Miller-Shockey. Dr. Aaron Munsell. Dr. Jennifer Stello. Dr. Danielle Reed. Dr. Teresa Shabilsky. Dr. Stephanie Johnson. Dr. Benjamin Dunay. Dr. Parker Liu. Dr. Kevin Hutton. Dr. Michelle Cook. Dr. Mariana Wildfire. Dr. Jessica Swanson. Dr. Megan Hollerbach. Dr. Tyler Gill. Dr. Frank Chilili. Dr. Emily Fritz. Dr. Jessica Arnold. Dr. Chelsea Bryant. Dr. Teresa Vigor. Dr. Caitlin Smith. Dr. Jonathan Skutnik. Dr. Hayden Block. Dr. Nolan Rupp. Dr. Amanda Lips. Dr. Samantha Johnson. Dr. Tyler Steffi. Dr. Scott Kallmeyer. Dr. Timothy Wazolewski. Dr. Kyle Fogg. Dr. Sarah Keene. Dr. Bradley Hahn. Dr. Robert Chizik. Dr. Kyle Erickson. Dr. Brandon Cushman. Dr. Rachel Tulaski. Dr. Janelle Wilson. Dr. Andrea McCarty. Dr. Trevor O'Meara. Dr. Jenna Day. Dr. Karen Parker. Dr. Preston Taylor. Dr. Mark Jordan. Dr. Amelia Demareth. Dr. Barbara Richmond. Dr. Lisa Feeney. Dr. Daniel Worthington. Dr. Kevin Hargis. Dr. Thomas Breeden. Dr. Benjamin Kowicki. Dr. Andrew Singles. Dr. Brianne Ovakatis. Dr. Tara Longman. Dr. Caitlin Anderson. Dr. Karen Gargaro. Dr. Faith Kirby. Dr. Eric Guti. Dr. Angela Nguyen. Dr. Kayla Brophy. Dr. Thomas Buschel. Dr. Juan Wang. Dr. Brian Palmer. Dr. Chunyin Young. Dr. Luke Zerbic. Dr. Bryce Welsh. Dr. Lauren Osinski. Dr. Samantha Schiffman. Dr. Danielle Schlacht. Dr. Timothy Brookeisen. Dr. Jennifer Brookeisen. Dr. Martha Cedarstaff. Dr. Megan Lasso. Dr. Josephine Fuentes. Dr. David Lieber. Dr. Robert Dubisky. Dr. Daniel Harsh. Dr. Jamie Campbell. Dr. Stephanie Edgington. Ladies and gentlemen, the doctoral graduates of the College of Pharmacy.
Will the candidates for the Educational Doctorate in Community College Leadership please rise? Will their families also rise? Dean Cheryl K. Clucci will present the candidates.
On behalf of the Community College Leadership Program, I am honored and privileged to present the candidates for the Educational Doctorate in Community College Leadership. They are hereby certified by the faculty for their degrees. The special hoods they wear represent the completion of the requirement for the doctoral degree.
By virtue of the authority vested in me, I confer upon you the degree, Educational Doctorate in Community College Leadership, of all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities therein. Congratulations, graduates.
Family members may be seated. Graduates, please come forward as directed by the ushers. Dr. Bruce Moses. Dr. Marilyn Jean Donham. Dr. Christine Moki Waltz. Dr. Leslie Ann Kellogg. Dr. Debbie Dawson. Dr. Salam Shabazz Bakum. Dr. Jennifer Szyszprowski. Dr. Jamie D. Baber. Dr. Talia Lynn Grunwitz. Dr. Brent Mishler. Dr. Amber Renee Holloway. Dr. Wanda Renee Hudson. Dr. Barbara Lynn Boutier. Dr. Daniel Robert Herbst. Dr. Jasmine Lee Dean. Dr. Glenn Richard Cerny. Dr. Lam Phun Wong. Dr. Robert Spohr. Ladies and gentlemen, the graduates in the Educational Doctorate in Community College Leadership.
Will the candidates for master's degree in the College of Arts and Sciences please rise? Will their families also rise? Dean Andy Karfa will present the candidates.
On behalf of the College of Arts and Sciences, I am honored and privileged to present these candidates for the Master of Social Work degree. They are hereby certified by the faculty for their degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me, I confer upon you this Master of Social Work degree as it applies to you individually, of all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities therein. Congratulations, Master's graduates, College of Arts and Sciences.
Family members may be seated. Graduates, please come forward as directed by the ushers. Tiffany Joanne Routley. Casey Sue Kingman. Angela Grace Knapp. Nicole Evangeline Carlin. Christina Elaine Schneit. Kayla Marie Thumb. Maya Jo Barnwell. Amanda Rose Webb. Jamie Lee Deveridge. Samantha F. Jensen. Jenna Mae Jenneru. Kara Marie Holcomb. Jennifer Renee Brenneman. Ladies and gentlemen, the master's graduates of the College of Arts and Sciences.
Will the candidates for baccalaureate and associate degrees in the College of Arts and Sciences please rise? Will their families also rise? Dean Andy Karfa will present the candidates.
On behalf of the College of Arts and Sciences, I am honored and privileged to present these candidates for the degrees of Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Integrative Studies, Bachelor of Science, Bachelor of Social Work, Associate in Applied Science, Associate in Arts, and Associate in Science. They are hereby certified by the faculty for their degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me, I confer upon you bachelor and associate degrees as they apply to you individually, with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities therein. Congratulations, graduates, College of Arts and Sciences.
Family members may be seated. Graduates may be seated except for the first row. Please come forward as directed by the ushers. Emily Seidel Garlick. Carson Ray Vischer. Trevor James Voice. Charles Wesley Williams III. Richard D. Hatcher. Mark E. Hansen, Jr. Angela Marie Sutton. Stacy M. Bowling. Hassan Nur Farah. Dustin James Rossler. Daniel G. Chilcote. Aaron L. Zabalski. Paige Marie Weaver. Patricia L. Whiting. Vanessa Paige Gibbs. Megan Ann Epley. Emily Haynes. Samantha Kelsey Humphrey. Victoria Ann Humphrey. Nicole Elizabeth Snell. Rebecca Jo Heemstra. Ashley Harvey. Christian Baumler. Chelsea Marie Wood. Rachel Alexandria Carnes. Desiree Ann Bruni. Mackenzie K. Wyrick. Megan Rahal. Hope Lynn Mulligan. Haley Fail Sewell. Tyler Allen Companion. Marissa A. Sanchez. Danielle Allen Severns. Rebecca Ann Dottles. Hannah A. Hoffman. Dylan Lee Lotholtz. Alexandra Paige Costa. Carmen Amber Zender. Rebecca Lee Weinberger. Rachel Ann Kapiski. Stephen Chase Veer. Bruce Allen Fout Jr. Mark Anthony Federley. Ashley Marie Summers. Gabriella Renee Hagen. Jennifer Lynn Scarbeck. Rosie Seitz. Anna Elizabeth Forster. Monica Ray Bisson. Rachel Marie Hartline. Kalila Sakea Woodward. Brianne Denise Johnson. Brittany Ann Presley. Carly Ann Pugh. Sloan Janae Sherrick. Morgan C. Doyle. Jordan Ann Marie Rasmussen. Julie Christine Reed. Brianne Nicole Baronsky. Evan Joseph Kleikamp. Matthew Richard Rico. Alyssa Jordan Divins. Carolyn A. Heitzman. Jordan P. McCulloch. Megan Ann Vandermeer. Stephen P. Yonker. Martin M. A. Unazi. Robert Joseph Pacella. Sarah Nicole Herbert. Luke S. Beyer. Jared Thomas Meehan. Mary Kate Vance. Zisha S. Tate. Alice Beth McKenna. Tamika Lasha Little. Taylor Reed Falkey. Molly Louise Reed. Wesley Dean Ricker. Samantha Lynn Kilmartin. Brianne M. Gardner. London Elia Johnson. Paige Elizabeth Fisher. Ann Riley Seesberger. Taylor Marie Gibson. Whitney Christina Nicole Olchevsky. Madeline A. Shell. Melissa J. Kuziak. Nathaniel Cole Pastrick. Nicole Marie Outman. Rajilla Lace Johnston. Andrew James Kirtlemeyer. Liesl Kaster. Nicholas Scott Chapman. Jared Scott Fadawa. Ashley Nicole Griggs. Angel Lynn Murda. Joshua Michael Ost. Jacqueline Christina Rolfs. Jessica Ann Dietrich. Nicole Lynn Russo. Elizabeth Ann Lewick. Brianna Marie Nickerson. David Ryan Everett Hannon. Zachary Paul Kramer. Ashley Ann Beaudry. Katie Nicole Lanning. Haley Jane Amlott. Marissa Blair Lombardo. Taylor James Michael Farmer. Brian Thomas Wheaton. Autumn Nicole Vandenberg. Beth Needham Sweeney. Travis Ryan Hill. Sultan Saud Abdul-Jabbar. Chelsea Rose Craig. Vida Pilar Espinosa. Nida Khan. Shauna Helene Langrock. Joshua Barry Andre Favorite. Brett Edward Walker. Daniel James Trinchita. Madeline Elaine Houston. Abigail A. Wagner. Ali Lou Wickland. Shannon Elaine Gamel. Catherine Amelia Rolka. Kara C. Versal. Tyler Kenneth Dietz. Rodney Keith Rice. Jacob David Laird. Devin Michelle Hodson. Jocelyn Kristen DeLouis. Danielle Renee Metz. Chelsea Joan Trumbull. Celia Elizabeth Robinson. Catherine Jean Wilson. Taylor Lynn Brenner. Lauren Marie McKenzie. Tyler Alexander Janeway. Andrew Thomas Sackett. Justine Kathleen Buddha. Michael Ryan Brown. Shane Herman Douglas. Ethan Joseph Laugel. Michael Francis Godinez. Joellen Elizabeth Maurer. Kellyn Marie Mulkey. Sundria A. Boykin. Sabrina Yvette Ramirez. Bradley Austin Root. Scott Daniel McDougall. Brianna Justine Rohn. Natalie Renee Watson. Abigail Thea Glumbeck. Catherine Mary Weaver. Spencer James Schuling. Catherine Mary Hart. Danielle Maria Barons. Lindsay Ann Barrett. Jamie Renee Richardson. Lonnie Hurst Daniel III. Jacoby DeAndre Mitchell. Come on. Abrina N. Hudson. Tracy Joyce Burgess. Christina Chame Branch. Haley Orlowski. Jessica Amber Bazan. Sarah Jean Monley. Elizabeth Marie Modrzynski. Jenna Lee Laszyski. Robert Joseph Gaudet. Connor Graham Bartz. Jennifer Lynn Wright. Nancy Marie Aldridge. Nathan William Klingel. Haley Mystic Klingel. Jordan Danielle Willick. Kira Ponson. Peyton Reese Caldwell. Stacy Ann Marie Thompson. Sylvia Charmaine Travis. Matthew J. Rupert. Haley Marie Burns. Shelby Joanne Taylor. Chantel Monique Ida Lee Elijah. Lindsay Marie Brunold. Lindsay Marie Sikowski. Jacqueline Christiana Beard. Austin Michael Caleb Hamilton. Okay. Justin Robert Furtz.
Robert E. Bob.
Andrew David Marcel.
Oh, very nice. Pashik.
Garrett Austin Pashik. Michael Werner Seidel. Megan Eileen Brown. W.C. Petty II. Philip Lyle Hartley. Mackenzie Ann Main. Rebecca Marie Betts. Michelle Marie Epsi. Dajiman Samad Mitchell. Ladies and gentlemen, the graduates of the College of Arts and Sciences.
Will all of our graduates please stand? There is a long-standing tradition at commencement ceremonies in which the graduates move their tassels from the right side to the left side of their caps as a symbol of your accomplishment. I invite all graduates of the class of 2016 to flip their tassels at this time. Congratulations and best wishes to each of you. Please be seated.
Jeremy Mishler, Associate Vice President for External Relations and Executive Director of the Ferris Alumni Association, will now bring you greetings from the Alumni Association.
It is now my great privilege to salute all of you for the first time as alumni of Ferris State University. From this day, you will face many new possibilities, probabilities, and challenges. We will now be depending on you to do your part to strengthen the economies of our world and to build our communities. And it is now, more than ever, that we will be counting on you to advocate to your family, neighbors, and colleagues the continuing opportunity of Ferris State. We are looking forward to your return to campus as our advisors, to be our guest speakers, and to share with us your successes so that your stories will inspire and support future generations that have the ability to fulfill their dreams here and one day stand at your side. Celebrate this great day. We look forward to hearing from you soon. And remember, you are and always will be a Bulldog.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the singing of Ferris Fidelity. You may join Rachel Schumann in singing our alma mater. The words are located in your program.
As constant as the northern star, our faith
Please remain standing for the formal closing of the commencement ceremony, and thank you for sharing this special day with us.